darkness affects us, as it often does, we all have the ability to reconnect with Source, to put our focus on God instead of ourselves. And there are a number of prayers that will change our energy. They've been used for centuries. The first is the Lord's Prayer, and it goes like this. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. The next is the ever-popular Hail Mary.
One of my favorites.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
The next one has a different name
than this, but what's coming to my head right now is the Glory Be.
So, glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was
in the beginning,
as it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. So, these prayers are very helpful to us when we forget to be in alignment with Source. So,
I come from a multi-paradigm background.
I believe in
reincarnation, and that is neither here nor there. The concept is that we forget what we came here for. And so
even if you don't believe in
reincarnation, you might believe that you were created with a particular purpose and have particular gifts.
So those gifts you did not create. At least that's this perception of the Catholic and Christian paradigm they were given to you. And so in the humility of this process, we use our gifts to help others. So when we forget our humility, these prayers are useful to return to that humility. Mary is the archetype of the perfect human being. And so she's very helpful to us, endlessly merciful toward us, especially when we lose our way and cannot feel our connection with Source, our connection with God, our connection with Christ. I use all of these terms, and you might use any number, or who knows?
Maybe you don't believe in God, but you were interested in this for some reason.
So I'm sharing these with you
because, amongst other things,
these prayers are hurtful to
unclean spirits,
cliffites in
Judaism,
demons, some other people might say,
even sometimes ghosts or other types of spirits.
If they are bothering you, these prayers prayed with intent I will be posting these videos unedited so that you can see this just the way it was. It's going to be interesting. So I'm looking forward to sharing this with you.
These prayers, when this is done, when we use these prayers to clear our minds or get
spirits off
of us, it is referred to as deliverance. Deliverance is a subset of exorcism. And that's one of the things that I wish to share with you
in the days, weeks, and months ahead.
And you'll be able to go back and look at these videos. And if you know me in the real world, you'll be able to ask me questions. I'll be
sharing more information
about how to contact me and stuff. So.